I'm sorry, though, that he came with Mr. Darcy. Don't say that. Why ever not? Jane. I've been so blind. What do you mean?
Mr. Darcy. I could more easily forgive his vanity had he not wounded mine.
Her sister Elizabeth is very agreeable.
Fairly tolerable, I dare say. Not handsome enough to tempt me. So what do you recommend to encourage affection?
Dancing. Even if one's partner is barely tolerable.
But no matter, I doubt we shall ever speak again.
Miss Elizabeth Bent.
Are you too proud, Mr. Darcy? And would you consider pride a fault or a virtue?
That I couldn't say.
Because we're doing our best to find a fault in you.
Maybe it's that I find it hard to forgive the follies and vices of others, or their offences against me. My good opinion, once lost, is lost forever.
Oh dear, I cannot tease you about that. What a shame, for I dearly love to laugh. Mr. Darcy?
Miss Elizabeth?
Not if I can help it. May I have the next dance, Miss Elizabeth?
May.
The first time I saw him at the assembly, he danced with nobody at all.
Did I just agree to dance with Mr. Darcy?
I knew nobody beyond my own party.
Oh, and nobody can be introduced in a ballroom. Mr. Darcy?
Miss Elizabeth.
What are you doing here? Mr. Darcy?
I came to Rosings with the single object of seeing you. I had to see you.
I do not have the talent of conversing easily with people I have never met before.
I trust your family is in good health, Miss Elizabeth.
What on earth have you done to poor Mr. Darcy?
I have no idea. You should take your aunt's advice and practice.
Why do you ask such a question?
To make out your character, Mr. Darcy.
What have you discovered?
Very little. I hear such different accounts of you as puzzle me exceedingly.
I hope to afford you more clarity in the future.
He saved the man from an imprudent marriage.
What's the matter?
I think it was a family that was considered unsuitable.
Jane?
So he separated them.
I don't understand.
I love you. Most ardently.
Mr. Darcy, when I was at Rosings.
From the first moment I met you, your arrogance and conceit, your selfish disdain for the feelings of others, made me realize that you were the last man in the world I could ever be prevailed upon to marry.
Forgive me, madam, for taking up so much of your time.
I thought you were in London.
No.
Does the young lady know Mr. Darcy?
Miss Elizabeth!
Only a little. I'm so sorry to intrude. They said that the house was open for visitors. I had no idea.
I shall not renew the sentiments which were so disgusting to you. But if I may, I will address the two offences you have laid against me. I came to leave you this.
Do you not think him a handsome man, miss?
Yes. Yes, I dare say he is.
Tomorrow we go to Matlock.
I return to town tomorrow. Tomorrow?
So soon.
Are you engaged to him?
I am not.
I believe you spoke with my aunt last night and it has taught me to hope, so I'd scarcely allowed myself before. If your feelings are still what they were last April, tell me so at once. My affections and wishes haven't changed. If, however, your feelings have changed, I will have to tell you. You have bewitched me, body and soul, and I love you. I never wish to be parted from you from this day on. Mrs. Darcy.